Hello, I'm here to show you how to precisely calibrate LUMOplay using our advanced calibration tools. To access the advanced tools, go to the menu in the top left, select Preferences, and select Advanced Calibration. You can also access this menu by hitting the F2 key on your keyboard. The advanced calibration tools look similar to the regular calibration tools, but there are a few additional controls. While it is better to mask and flip your display area in the main calibration screen, and not in this advanced screen, the mask and flip tools are available here if you need to do slight adjustments or flip or mirror the screen if the movement is on the wrong side of the screen. To configure most floor and wall setups, I like to set the sensitivity to zero at the start. I will readjust this at the end when the rest of the settings are where we want them to be. Before we start, let's make sure to clear the interaction area of anything that's not supposed to be there, like ladders, people, and furniture. We will now use this button here to capture a clean snapshot of the environment. Notice how the screen looks a lot flatter now. We will then use the interpolation dropdown to change how LUMOplay interprets the data from the camera. By default, the interpolation is set to linear. This works well with most setups, while being fairly forgiving if your calibration isn't perfect. But since we are calibrating for maximum accuracy, we will set the interpolation to step. Notice that the feed has gone almost entirely black. It may have also gone almost entirely white, depending on your setup. We are now going to adjust the detection range. For a floor, you want to be at around a 5 to 6 foot range. For a wall ball setup, you want it between 1 and 2 feet. I am configuring a floor with a low ceiling, so I will aim for around a 5 foot range. But another thing to keep in mind is that we are using the step interpolation. We will actually need to double our desired range, so I will be aiming for roughly a 10 foot range. Now comes the tricky part. We need to move both of these sliders around while keeping the detection range around where we want it to be. And what we're trying to find is the exact transition point when it switches from black into from entirely black to entirely white. And right here is that transition point where we're getting just a lot of little pieces of noise. So I want to step it back a little bit, and that's what these little arrows do. The arrows on this side adjust this slider, and the arrows on this side adjust this slider. So, not quite the 10 feet I was aiming for, but 9 foot 6 is close enough. And now we can see that the any motion that occurs in the scene now is very, very precise. It does not detect anything on the floor itself, but it detects anything that happens to be above the floor. We can now take the sensitivity and turn it up as high as possible without getting phantom noise in the detection area. You may get some around the edges, as long as they do not overlap the area, then we should be fine. Again, we can use these fine tuning controls here to get this exactly where we want it to be. And now when I move over top of it, we get nice define motion. And you can adjust the noise reduction. You want it as low as possible without compromising your sensitivity. If you turn it up too high, then everything just gets really, really blurry and you get very undefined blobs. So we try to keep that as low as possible. 1 or 2 are very acceptable. And we do not mess with the delay at all. We leave it wherever its default is. It usually defaults to 1. It sometimes defaults to 2 depending on your setup type. And now that we're done here, we have a very precise setup. You can see my feet fine. You can see my hands, anything in between. And now we can launch a game. I hope this helps you set everything up yourself, and if you have additional questions, please head over to help.lumoplay.com.